Follow us with the mini lab.
We're going to show you how science can be used to answer questions about rare items.
The cart we have here is our portable instrument cart, which is kind of our lab on the go, or our mini lab. We have all of our portable instruments that we can actually remove from the lab and bring to collection items or collection spaces to help answer these questions that curators and conservators have about these items. We had a question come in from an outside researcher about 18th century artist manuals, which are manuals that were written by artists to kind of teach other artists in training how to mix materials. So she had questions about some of the marks that were found on a lot of these books that she was looking at. So we have one here present from the 18th century. Her specific question was how these manuals were used, whether they were just meant to be written and produced for the rich to be put on their bookshelf as kind of a symbol of their status, or if they were actually used by these members of the family to learn how to create art and create pigments. One of these books here really fascinating because we actually found this wash of red that you see kind of on the inside of the book, and you can actually see that it is highlighting the chapter of reds and how to make red pigments. So we are actually going to look at this artist manual and the red swatch with our portable microscope.
It's so tiny.
You can see the ink and some of the paper fibers, and you can kind of see the overall red wash. This information actually tells us that it is more of a dye pigment. The researchers really wanted to identify what this red wash actually was, whether it was an artist material or just a writing material, because that can help their interpretation of how the books were used. And we were able to identify it as one of the red pigments that is found on following pages. So it kind of proves that whoever was using this book actually tested out one of the recipes and then used that pigment to highlight a section in the book. And that helps the interpretation that these books were not just meant for a bookshelf, they were actually used by their owners to practice creating the pigments and how to paint and work on art. And it helps add to the value of the item.
I think it's interesting to learn how we use science in this case to add to our historical understanding of these collection items. Like with this 18th century artist manual, we now have new information that wouldn't be possible without some of the science that you're doing. So how might an aspiring researcher at home or in the classroom use an item like this?
So whereas some of our instruments are very expensive and a little more advanced to use, we do have these very accessible portable instruments like this portable microscope that is very inexpensive comparatively and can connect to something as easy as a laptop. We also have a little color photometer that gives you color information, which can start giving you a little bit more comparative information to what we have discussed. My background is in chemistry and conservation, which is physically preserving the collection items, which really set me up well for a job here as a preservation science specialist, because I'm able to use the knowledge of the science and the conservation to not only answer these questions about the materiality and what it is, but also how to keep it around as long as possible.